Hello children, welcome to your language class. In the previous class, we studied about two rules how to change a singular noun into plural noun. Today, we'll study rule number 3 of conversion of singular into plural. Let's see. If a singular noun ends with a Y preceded by a consonant, then plural noun is formed by dropping the letter Y and adding I-E-S. Pay attention once more. If a singular noun ends with a Y, it means any word, any singular noun whose last alphabet is letter Y. Then what happens? And in a condition that Y is preceded by a consonant. Preceded means which comes before. So before Y, if there is a consonant before Y, then what will happen? Will form plural noun by dropping letter Y. Means we will remove letter Y from there and we will add I-E-S. Let's see examples. Lady, we can see here L-A-D-Y. What is preceded by Y? Before Y you can see a consonant. D. D is a consonant. So if consonant is there before Y, then we will remove Y and we will add I-E-S and it becomes ladies. In the same way, city. Here we can see what's there before Y? T. T is also a consonant. So in this case also we will drop letter Y from here and we will add I-E-S instead of Y and it will become cities. In the same way, army. M is also a consonant which comes before Y. So we will remove Y and we will add I-E-S and it will become armies. In the same way, story will become stories. Fly, flies. Salary, salaries. Lily, lilies. Duty, duties. So in all these examples, we saw that Y is preceded by a consonant. So in all these words, we will drop letter Y and instead we will add I-E-S. Let's see this also. Here also, it's one butterfly. So butterfly. Here we can see two of them. So we will write butterflies. And what happened here? As here it was letter L. L is a consonant before Y. So we will remove letter Y and we will add I-I-E-S. And it will become butterflies. In the same way, candy, we can see D before Y. It's a consonant. So, we'll change it into candies by dropping letter Y and adding I-E-S. So, it becomes candies. Now, this letter Y also have an exception. We can see here. However, if a singular noun ends with Y and is preceded by a vowel. So what is most important part here? Vowel. Here we saw that it was preceded by a consonant. Now here it's preceded by a vowel. Then the plural is formed by adding S. So it also becomes a general rule type that if before Y there is a vowel, then we will add letter S. And we will not drop letter Y. Y will be there, just we will add letter S. Let's see examples. Play. We can see here before Y, what's there? A. A is a vowel. So it will become plays. Simply we will add letter S. Toy will become toys. Story will become stories. Day will become days. Key, keys. Valley, valleys, donkey, donkeys, ray, rays. So in all these words, we saw that Y is preceded by a vowel, like here A, O, E, A, E, 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 A. All these letters are vowel. So Y is preceded by vowel. So we will simply add S at the end. Let's see here also. One monkey is here, so monkey. As we can see, Y is preceded by a vowel. So here, while changing it into plural form, we will add only S. In the same way, key, E is also a vowel. So here also, simply we will add S. So today, we studied the third rule, that if Y is preceded by a consonant, then we will drop letter Y and add IES. And if Y is preceded by a vowel, in that case, we will simply add S after the word in order to make it plural. Hope so that rule number third is clear to you all. We will see rest of the rules in next class. Till then, thank you, children.